So, if you first look at this system of equations, you might be thinking, this is really hard because this is a nonlinear system of equations because of the product of ab, ac, or abc, things like that. And we don't want to do like so many substitution for this. But I will tell you, there's actually a much easier way to do it besides the substitution method. And the reason that we know that is because notice that we have the sum of abc, the product of abc, as well as we have ab plus ac plus bc. Whenever this happens, we can use Vieta's formula and we can turn this into a cubic equation. Let me write that down right here for you guys. This right here, by Vieta's formula, I will tell you a, b, c are the roots for the following cubic equation. Starting with x cubed, and then we are going to subtract. Here we will have a plus b plus c, and then x squared. And then we are going to add the product of any of the two letters, and then you add them up. So we have ab plus ac plus bc, and then x. And lastly, we will have to subtract the product of all three, a, b, c. So a, b, c. And all that is equal to 0. So the first term is positive, and then negative, and then positive, negative. And then you start with the sum, and then the sum of like the product of two letters, and then lastly, the product of all three. So that's how you can remember it. Well, to see why this is the case, you can start off by writing this down. X minus A times X minus B times X minus C, and it's equal to 0. Expand it, and then you can match coefficients. I'm going to leave this to you, or you can check out my other video for a detailed explanation for this. But today, let's just focus on solving the cubic equation. Here we go. First, we will have x cubed, and then minus a plus b plus c, which is equal to negative 1, and then times x squared. Continue plus this right here is negative 5, multiply that with x. And then minus the product of abc, which is 2. And all that is equal to 0. So thanks to the Vieta's formula, we just have to solve this cubic equation, which is the same as x cubed plus x squared minus 5x minus 2 is equal to 0. Unfortunately, we cannot just do factor by grouping with the first two terms and the last two terms. So let's try the rational zero theorem. The last term right here is a minus 2, and the leading coefficient is 1. So we just have to try 1, 2, negative 1, and negative 2. If you're plugging 1 into all the x's, it's not going to work. But if you do 2, it will. 2 cubed is 8, 2 squared is 4. So 8 plus 4 is 12, 5 times 2 is 10. 12 minus 10 is 2, minus 2 is 0. So right here, I'll just make a note. X equals 2 works. And then you can just do the sensitivity division. But I have done that with you guys so many times. Today, I'll show you guys something that's slightly fancier or something that's a little bit more sophisticated. Here's the deal. Since we know x equals 2 works, I am going to look at the x to the third power term, but do not subtract 2 because x cubed minus 2 cannot factor that easily. However, if you do 2 cubed is 8. If we put x cubed with minus 8 together, this is so much easier to factor. Okay, this is just a number. Well, originally our constant term is negative 2. So we will have to utilize that. We have negative 8 right here. So that means I will have to have a plus 6 because negative 8 plus 6 will give us the negative 2. We broke down negative 2 into this and that, and then it will be the same thing, and it's going to help us to factor. Let's write down the rest that we didn't do, and then I'll tell you, if you now you look at these two terms and these three terms, it's factorable. X cubed minus 2 cubed, we get x minus 2 times x squared plus 2 times x plus 2 squared, which is 4. Factoring this, we get x minus 2, x minus 3. And we see x minus 2 is in common. So let's factor that out. And then we will just have this right here, x squared plus 2x plus 4, and then combine with x minus 3. So we are looking at x minus 2 times the quadratic x squared plus 3x plus 1. It's equal to 0. X minus 2 equals 0. We have that already. So we just have to solve this right here real quick. So x squared plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. And right here, because the coefficient of x is an odd number, so I will just do the quadratic formula. X will be negative b, which is 3, plus or minus square root b squared minus 4ac, a is 1, c is 1, all over 2a is 1. And we will get negative 3 plus or minus square root, that's 9, minus 4, which is 5, over 2, like this. All right, so as we can see, we have the first solution, and then if you use the positive, that's the second solution. If you use the negative here, you have the third solution. All right, so we got x, but the thing is that, remember, the goal is to solve for a, b, and c. So how are we going to do it though? Well, the idea here is that we have A, B, and C already. They're just up to permutations because you just have to kind of assign the values to them according to like different orders. So we can do the following to present the answer. Put A equals 2, and then B equals the one with the positive, so negative 3 plus square root of 5 over 2, and then C equals the one with negative here. Negative 3 minus square root of 5 over 2. So this is the first triple for the solutions right here. Or you can just kind of arrange them. You can say A equals this, which actually I will keep A equals 2 again, and then B equals the negative version. So negative 3 minus square root of 5 over 2. C equals the positive version then. And the truth is you have 6 ways to arrange them. I'm not going to write them down, right? So I'll just say this. And this is a fancier way to say it. If you don't want to write down all the possibilities, you can say A, B, C are this, up to permutation. And you have a total of 6 possible triples for that. All right? So hopefully you guys all like this. That's it.